Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to reflect this morning on the importance of affirmation. In Hebrew, the word that encapsulates affirmation is bracha. And I very firmly believe, based on what I've experienced, and I suspect you all can bear this out, that we human beings, we need affirmation, we need bracha, and consequently, we should think very carefully about how we can offer affirmation and bracha, blessing to each other. The other night, I was teaching our high school students, our youth house students, and I asked them to pair up and to reflect on two things. One, a time that they remember that somebody insulted them, that somebody said something that brought them down. And two, a time that someone said something that affirmed them and lifted them up. It didn't take them long to think of either. Maybe they first thought of the insulting moment, but it didn't take long after that for them to think of a moment when someone, a friend or a teacher or a member of their family, said something that lifted them up. Affirmation, bracha, it can come as an expression of confidence. I believe that you have what it takes to accomplish a certain task. It can come as a compliment. What you did was terrific. You expressed yourself beautifully. You handled yourself with dignity in a difficult situation. It can come in the form of validation of something difficult. What you are going through right now is really hard. I see that. It must be hard for of blessing, and I want to point out two, which I believe are instructive to us. Jacob is turning to his grandsons and saying, "Hamalach hagoel oti yevarech et ha'ne'arim." The angel who was with me and who redeemed me, let that angel also be a source of blessing for you. Jacob is at the end of his life. He realizes that. And what he's doing is he is saying, the blessings that I receive, the protection that I receive, I want you to have the same blessings, the same protection, the same affirmation. So what we learn from Jacob, I believe, is that when we recognize the blessings in our lives and to the extent that we feel the affirmation that we have been given, we have an obligation to pay that forward to somebody else, to give them that energy, if you will, of affirmation, of blessing. And then there is a second moment where, as I referred to earlier, Joseph's brothers are terrified after their father dies. They are terrified that the brothers are going to come after, that he's going to come after them, and he's going to harm them and maybe kill them. And he says to them, "Al tira'u, don't be afraid. You may have had bad intentions regarding me. God intended for my coming down to Egypt to be a source of kalkala, to be a source of sustenance for not just you, but for all of the people. And don't worry, I will take care of you." From this, I believe, we learn that through affirmation, we can confront people's insecurities. We can say, even to somebody who meant us harm, that we are able to get past that. We can give them the affirmation that life will go on even after someone misstepped, even despite someone's fears and someone's insecurities. I want to just give an example of how this can happen. So the other day I was on a Zoom meeting with a whole group of colleagues, a bunch of rabbis. And at a certain point, I have to admit my mind wandered a little bit. One of my colleagues, someone I've known for a long time, was speaking about handling a particularly difficult ethical situation that she was charged with handling. And I was listening and I was following, and it was important for me, like everybody else, to be able to offer feedback. But what I did privately was I messaged her and I said, I have known you now for almost 30 years, and I am consistently impressed by the intelligence and dignity with which you handle difficult situations. Now, we can do that for each other. She appreciated it. We all appreciate when somebody sees the best in us, when somebody elevates that. And if we can be specific, it's even better to be specific so it doesn't sound like we're just trying to be nice. We say something specific that the person knows is true. We elevate that, and that is a moment of very important affirmation. I want to say something which we need to consider, and that is, when we affirm someone else, it doesn't take away from us. Sometimes we think that there's a limited amount of affirmation. If I say something nice to you, if I compliment you, maybe it means that, I don't know, I'm not who knows what. So first of all, when we offer somebody a compliment, it doesn't diminish anything about us. And secondarily, and no less importantly, when we affirm someone else's struggle, it doesn't mean that our struggle is any less. We can affirm someone's struggle, a personal struggle, a communal struggle, a struggle that is based on circumstance of religion or race or gender, and the list can go on. And that doesn't mean that our struggle is any less. In fact, if I may borrow the image from Hanukkah, which is still in our memories, one candle lights another candle, and both candles then are allowed to burn. When we give affirmation of something positive, when we affirm something difficult and challenging that another person is experiencing, both the person who gives and the person who receives are illuminated and elevated. I want to share one more image before I conclude. So a few days ago, I attended the funeral service for Renee Ricky Fenster, the wife of Rabbi Myron Fenster, who served this congregation for a few years as interim senior rabbi. Ricky was universally loved, not just liked, loved. And if I take a step back and try to understand why it is that she was so loved, it is because she is somebody who naturally, elegantly, intentionally affirmed other people. The people who came in contact with her felt that she saw them, that she heard them, that she cared about them, because her words and her actions suggested that kind of affirming concern. The rabbis asked the question, Ezehu mechubad, who receives honor? And the answer they gave, HaMechabed et HaBriot, the one who honors others, that person receives honor. Ricky was mechubedet. She was honored in large measure because she was mechabedet, because she honored other people. So, ladies and gentlemen, as we finish Sefer Bereshit, the book of Genesis, we will continue to face life's challenges, personal and communal and global. I encourage us to think about the power of bracha, the power of blessing, the power of affirmation. We can give it. As much as we want to receive it, we should understand the importance of giving it. Who did something great that we can affirm? Who is struggling whom we can recognize? V'nisa beracha me'et Adonai, may we, like Jacob, carry the blessings that God has given us so that we can pass them on and affirm each other. We all need it. Shabbat shalom.